opportunity for Team Kinda Deep to get off the field because Drake did not execute. And right there, they're keeping everything in front of them from a secondary perspective. They're not allowing Drake to get behind them for the deep play. They're going to say, if you're going to beat us, you're going to have to beat us throwing the ball underneath and then running and trying to make a play out with your feet.
In a sense, you've got a very physical Mexican defense going up against what's basically an offense built on deception.
Yeah,
and right now, the physical is winning.
Exactly. And defense is easier to kind of get yourself ready for or get ready for as opposed to offense because of the nuances, especially of this particular offense. Good punt there because that was a little close. They almost got it blocked there. Great job by the kicker,
Jansen,
getting the ball off. I mean, that was pretty close.
And Irving Barrera took a fair catch, so he just took the ball and no one could hit him. On the side, he actually had a little room to run.
I was wondering why, you know, he fair caught that. Maybe it's one of those deals where you're not as comfortable, you know, with your blocking up front. You don't really know the guys, so they know the system. So, you know, sometimes it's a little better just to be safe than sorry, I suppose.
Juan Leon is the running back. Ortiz, though, is throwing. They set up a wide receiver screen, but it's not going anywhere. And it's going to be a loss of a couple of yards, which will make it second down and about 13 from about the 20-yard line.
Just watching that play there again, that was what they call a bubble screen to try to get the ball to the receiver as quickly as possible and allow him to run with the football. And not a very good throw there by Ortiz. He needs to really step and throw the ball and get it to the receiver. Give him a chance.
This time Ortiz is keeping. He was looking to the outside where he had a man, a receiver out there to take the pitch. That was Escobedo, 15, but he decided to keep it himself. And the option there, that didn't fool Drake at all.
Great job there. What's called keeping leverage on the football as the end man on the line of scrimmage, not allowing yourself to get outflanked, and then not taking the bait of the little fake Ortiz gave and really getting after the quarterback and keeping him inside and waiting for the pursuit or your other defenders to come and help you to make the tackle.
So that makes it third down and about 7. Ortiz again throwing underneath.
Oh, excellent job there on the stop. Stops him short of the first down. Good job by the defender of stopping him short of the first down. Now it's going to be interesting to see what the Team Kinda Deep does deep in their own territory. They've had a lot of trouble kicking the ball. Will they decide to punt or go for it?
It's fourth and about a yard. The players, the offensive players for Kinda Deep, are all saying, let's go for it.
And at this point, I that might be a better option.
In fact, they're calling for a measurement, but it was well short of the first down.
Yes, it's at least a yard and a half short from the first down. So I still say it wouldn't be a bad idea to go for it, even down here with this situation. But I guess we are going to get a measurement.
Yeah, so you see now the sticks coming in. The chain between those two sticks is exactly 10 yards long. You take a look at some of the VIP section here, enjoying the match in the shade. There's the president of Drake University. Sports Ministry, fantastic stuff here. Great atmosphere at the Sheikh Amri Abeid Stadium. And, okay, they've taken a look at how far they have to go, and they decide they will kick it away.
Now let's see if we can get a good snap by the snapper to the kicker. And watch, for our viewers, watch how long the kicker, or how many steps the kicker takes before he kicks the ball. That's something that the timing with this is pretty critical. And just wondering, I said, that looks like a lineman kicking.
Yeah.
Interesting.
he's been doing punting. Fernando Rubalcaba and the kickoffs.
Well, this is going to be interesting to see, especially for, you know, the snap and how he receives the ball and how quickly he can get it off.
The snap is the big thing, and you have motion now in the line for the Mexicans, and the pretend rush by Drake forced movement inside, I think it was Rodrigo Urrea, who's a linebacker. So this is the only time he plays on the offensive side of the ball. But that'll march them back five more yards.
Lack of discipline. That's the issue there when you have false starts or penalties from a false start standpoint. That's lack of discipline on the receiving of the kicking team part.
Well, that snap was slow, but it was better. And the kick, again, is a line drive, but it takes a good bounce for Kona Dayton. And not much running room for Mike Lahard, who took the kick. But very much like the Drake punt at the end of the first quarter, where it came down on the bounce, and instead of taking the fair catch, Lahard tried to return it.
And right there, you know, great job of coverage by Team Kona Deep of getting down there and swarming the football, keeping it inside and in front of you, and then breaking down to make the tackle. You know, for a minute there, had he, you know, fielded it cleanly, it looked like they had an opportunity to make some yards, because I think they were setting up for the return.
And there is a penalty on the return. You saw the referee, there he is, with the white hat on, Bill Lemonnier, who in January was refereeing the National College Championship game in the United States. He wears a white hat. The other officials wear black hats, and they come from three different countries, one from Mexico, one from Poland, as well as from the United States. Another personal foul, so again, lack of discipline, really hurting. And there you see the snap. That's the key play. It was slow, but it was a good job by Ruvakaba of actually picking it up off the ground and getting the kick away.
And you got to wonder, like I said, with all these personal foul penalties, you know, rule differences between countries and how the game is played, little nuances that, you know, are called a little differently from one area to the next.
So first down and 10 for Drake. The Bulldogs have Castro back in at quarterback. And a nice little bit.
And the one thing I'm seeing with this team kind of deep, the defensive line is doing a great job of getting penetration and getting to the back or the quarterback in the backfield, as opposed to getting pushed with your front line or your offensive line and forcing the defense to play on their side of the line of scrimmage. It seems here each time they're playing on they're looking here. We're watching the good punt coverage, and you see there Jose Reyes doing a real good job of getting down there and making a good tackle.
I didn't see a penalty on that, so I don't know. It must have been off the ball.
Maybe a dead ball foul, possibly.
And there is a timeout on the field.
I believe we have a player down for a team kind of deep. He gets up. It's number 10. Huerta, Jose Huerta, and you know, you like to see kids get up, because that's another thing that you don't want to see in games like this, where you get potential injuries, and you know, you got to go back home on that flight. It's a pretty long flight, and you don't want to be injured on a, you know, 2 8-hour flights.
And you certainly don't want to put your season in the autumn into jeopardy.
Exactly.
Either. It's quite a few people still coming into the stadium as we're in the second quarter, and the stands to our left and right at the left end zone and the right end zone have both been filling up rather considerably since the start of the game, which is great. Better late than never.
Exactly.
So it's going to be second down and about 9 yards to go for a first down.
Well, let's see what Tyler Castro does here. You know, took him out there for a minute. See if he calms down and kind of gets on rhythm here. Good job there throwing the football and making the catch there by number
Alex
84.
Sasania made the catch. And that's a tough pass, because that's a long way to throw the ball for just a few yards.
Great job here trying to catch him off guard. Didn't quite work.
I don't know if he's looking for a flag or not, but that looked like a pretty clean hit to me.
Well, I think it was more he was thinking maybe they were offsides by the defense, and they just didn't get the call. And we're putting this tricky situation again. They're going to punt. But as you were saying, that's a pretty difficult throw. But I'm just wondering why Drake is not doing more of that quick throw, because team kind of deep, the defense is playing off. They're giving him the 3 to 5 yard throw every time. And, you know, my old coach, Lou Holtz, always said, if it's not broke, don't fix it. We'll keep running until they stop it.
Right. So Jansen is on to punt the ball away for Drake. This time a high kick. And again, a fair catch, and that's good, a good kick, because he puts the ball inside the 10-yard line with no possibility of a return, and Kona Deep is going to take over with the ball just on the 10-yard line, first and 10.
And this is shaping up to be a game truly of field position, and really, Drake has dominated that all game long, and a lot of that has come from two different things, penalties by Team Kona Deep, and a better special teams play by Drake.
So Kona Deep, first and 10 at their own 10. Ortiz from Toluca University is still the quarterback, and Juan Carlos Leon is the running back. Comes from the state of Mexico Tech. The bulk of the players on the team from Monterey Tech, from Toluca, and from UDLA, the University de los Americas, University of Americas in Pueblo, Mexico.
And American football is really starting to take off there in Mexico, and it's good to see, you know, all these different schools coming together and putting a team together, and some good athletes.
Leon picks up about four. Yeah, I mean, offensively, it's almost the same story. They're trying to use size and power to overcome a slightly smaller and maybe quicker defense.
And it has been working for the most part. And I think, like I said, when they're able to get a push up front, or, you know, get some movement up front by their offensive line, they're having success in, you know, getting 2, 3, 4 yards a pop. But it's when they allow penetration by the defense, and that's the one thing with that zone read in the running game that really hurts, is when you allow penetration up front, it really puts you at a disadvantage.
So gain of about 3 yards, long two or short three, second down and seven from the 13. And again, they keep it on the ground, and again, took a good hit there, and there was a little exception to that taken, but that's just the case of a runner keeping his feet and going and basically inviting another hit to try to stop him.
Nice hit by Hall. I mean, he really redirected Reyes and turned him around, but you got to like, again, we're third and short, third and two right there. Good job of getting the ball and getting push up front by the offensive line of Team Kona Deep. And I think this is an area where you can have success, and it helps you develop and get into a rhythm offensively.
Third down and short, and you can see, well, there's a timeout taken by Drake on third and short. Drake were putting everybody up on the line of scrimmage, expecting a run, and I think somebody may have changed their mind.
Well, I think I know why they changed their mind, because Team Kona Deep went to an empty set. The running back lined up as a receiver, and I think Coach Creighton was like, hold up. That's not exactly what we're expecting them to do. So they really moved back, and smart call. I think it was a smart call on Coach Creighton's part, and kind of a tricky call by Coach Maya to you know, because you think third and short and how they've been running the ball. As a coach, I would think, hey, they're going to try to run the ball again. Let's see if we can stop them. And they jump into a empty set where all the you have no one in the backfield except the quarterback. That's usually considered a passing formation.
So the timeout charged to Drake as they get to reset themselves. Kona Deep facing a third down and about 2 yards to go. There's a picture of the American football field. Here's that hit, as you talk about, a good way to redirect the runner.
And Graez is a really tough back. Just watch him in practice. And he's one of the leaders on Team Kona Deep, one of the kids that they really look to for leadership. And, you know, he's a tough runner, great job keeping his feet moving, legs churning, and trying to get those extra yards.
So Drake now in a more normal defense. They're not walking everybody up to the line of scrimmage. And Kona Deep in their more normal set. And they're going to keep it on the ground. And they're not going to get the first down.
Well, looking from the head linesman,
they
think
no,
he
they
have
did.
Gotten it.
Yeah, I shouldn't have said it.
He squirted. Look at it. I thought he got stopped short too, but he kind of squirted through there. And that's what, you know, as a small running back, that's one of the advantages of being short and squatty. You can kind of squeeze through small
holes. Reggie, you're short. You're not small.
Well, I used to be.
You got a good center of gravity. So first and 10 on the first down for Conadepe, and they keep it on the ground again. Samuel King Wong.
Yes.
That's his first carry.
And he's a bit of a change of pace back. He's a little bigger than Reyes and Gonzalez. So he adds a little bit of change of pace to the backfield, and that's a good thing for Team Conadepe. Right there, 5 yards again, and you're moving the ball on the ground. Let's see if they can continue that momentum.
And again, they keep it on the ground. Tripped up at the line of scrimmage, but still stumbles forward for about 3 yards on the ground. And that was Roberto Gonzalez. So they really are shuttling the running backs in. That's four running backs they've used already.
Keeping guys fresh, and again, we're in a third and two, long two, short three, and that's a very manageable down and distance, and that's where you want to be as an offense. Put yourselves in situations where, you know, you can have success.
Everybody blocking down to the left.
Oh, excellent job by number 44 for Drake.
That's the linebacker, Tyler Moorhead, they said in unison. Because everything was coming right. They were pulling the line and pushing it all to the right, the running back coming behind him. Moorhead stood his ground, fought off the blockers, and again, well, again, the players want to go for it, but again, it's almost 2 yards they've got to go, and you know, down only 3-0 and deep in your own territory, it's safer thing to do is to punt the ball away. But one thing this has also done is given their defense a bit of a break.
Yes,
and they needed it.
And again, you know, the flow of the game has shifted a little bit, where you're getting a little more momentum from Team Conadepe, and they're taking advantage of it, moving the ball. Not having great success, but as you said, keeping the defense off the field and giving a little bit of rest.
So that snap right in Ruvalcaba's hands, and the kick is spinning, and it will go out of bounds around the 38-yard line or so.
Got another flag on the field. I wonder if this says someone moved a little early, maybe, on the Team Conadepe.
It's an offside against Conadepe.
Yeah, I thought that looked like someone got a little early start there.
Which I think, by my count, makes 7 penalties against them and none so far against Drake. But it looks like that Drake's going to make them kick it again, which is probably a smart move considering how shaky the kicking game has been.
Yes, and again, give yourself, you know, a little better field position, because that forces them back about 5 more yards. And the kicker has been a little shaky in terms of his punting, how well he's been able to do. Looks like they're debating whether they're going to do it or not.
Yeah, okay. The punting team came back on. Yeah, now they are. Now they're moving the ball back. But the punting team had come on for the for Conadepe, and then all of a sudden it looked like someone was reconsidering. And so it'll be a second attempt at the punt.
And it'd be interesting here to see if Drake comes after the punter. You know, last couple of times they've tried to set up the return. It'll be interesting to see if they try to, you know, make a play here and get after the punter, because he takes up more. Normally it's about 2 steps and the ball should be gone. He's about 2.5, maybe 3, and he's really taking his time. That's something, you know, you have to do in rhythm. It may be because he's not the normal punter. But I know he's been here the whole time, but he just doesn't seem very comfortable back there as a kicker.
And Drake looked like they are going to send people. You have a choice between you rush the kicker or you put your guys back to block for your returner. And again, it's a low line drive kick, and the kicker was hit hard, and that's going to be the first penalty against Drake for roughing the kicker.
Now you got a choice here. It's the 15-yard kind. So it's a great opportunity for Team Conadepe to actually move the ball. One of those, you know, they were coming after the ball. It's one of those, oh, not quite there. Should have pulled off. You know, Drake tried to go for the big play, didn't make it, and it's going to cost him.
And now you can start second-guessing that decision not to take
exactly
the ball where it was, but to try to improve your field position. And one thing because the kicker, when he lets go of the ball, is basically unprotected, you cannot hit him. If you're going to hit him, you have to hit the ball first. And that just did not happen. He was knocked over. It's a 15-yard penalty. That's the first penalty against Drake in this game. And it gives Konadape back the ball, and it gives him great field position. First down and 10, right at the 40-yard line.
Now let's see if Team Konadape can take advantage of this and continue to move the ball. They had a lot of success there. And good job by Ortiz keeping the ball.
And he basically, he and Ken Wong were both holding that ball for about three steps, and he finally pulled it away, and Ken Wong fell at the feet of a tackler and wound up throwing a good block for him.
And Wong is going off. He's a little shaken up there. I think, like you said, they kind of both were holding that ball. He waited to the very last second to pull it and run there by Ortiz. But a good job there. First down, they're moving the ball, moving the chain. And you got to wonder, you know, is the Drake defense getting a little bit tired? Because when you're running the ball, constantly coming at you, it kind of puts you on your heels a little bit.
First and 10 at the 51, at the 49-yard line. They're into Drake territory. A pickup of 11 by Ortiz. And again, they go up the middle of another flag flies. These guys are squaring off inside. The gain was about 2, but let's see where the penalty is going to go.
Very good job by Drake at the point of attack of not allowing them to get pushed.
Oh, and it's a face mask call. You can see, you could see the signal there from referee Bill Lemonnier as he pulls at the imaginary face mask in front of his own face. And so Drake is penalized 15 yards again. Well, they hadn't had any penalties up till two plays ago. Now they've lost 30 yards in the space of three plays.
And as you said earlier, before we start, when we started the broadcast, this game is about field position. And right there, they just gave up 30 yards of field position and really put Team Konadape in a good situation. Let's see if they can take advantage.
First and 10 at about the 30-yard line for Konadape. And Ortiz is going to throw on first down. It's going to be incomplete. Nice call there to try to catch Drake off balance because they would be expecting the run.
Very good call. And this is the thing what really hurts this offense more than anything is in the passing game is the timing of the routes. You had two what are called stop routes where the receivers run to a point and then just stop and turn around toward the quarterback. And not very good timing between the quarterback and the receiver. And not a very good read by Ortiz because he should have gone to the inside receiver, or this receiver closer to the ball.
And he's going to throw again, but this time it's just a little shovel pass to Race, who's got some running room, makes a nice cut, and he's got a first down and more deep into Drake territory, and a nice job of running by Race.
And it will count as a pass, but that's basically a handoff. The inside shovel pass, what you look for is to get that defensive end to come up the field and get out of position and get the little running back to come underneath, a little shovel pass. Great run by Reyes. Great job of keeping his feet and reading his block.
First and 10 at the 13 for Konadape.
Drake was ready for that shovel pass that time.
Yeah, sometimes you go back to the well too often, but they do pick up a couple of yards.
And actually, I like what Ortiz did there. At first, it wasn't there. The defender had it, and he just hesitated just enough for the running back to clear and give himself a good open pass so he could give it to him.
Second down now at about 8 at the 10-yard line. And Ortiz fakes the handoff and tries to keep it, but he's not getting anywhere. And he's fumbled the ball, and Drake has recovered the ball. Ortiz lost possession. Drake has recovered. And in that case, I think it was once too often for Ortiz turning around. Robbie Unger, the man who made the stop.
And right there, Ortiz not very secure with the football. That's something, you know, as a quarterback, as a running back, receiver, anyone that's responsible for taking care of the football or carrying the football, you've got to take care of the football. And in that situation, just a little lax, the ball hanging down by side. Great job by Travis Merritt. Another play by Travis Merritt of coming in, getting the quarterback from behind and stripping the ball.
So again, the Mexicans are switching running backs, and Drake is switching quarterbacks as Tyler Enns is back in at quarterback for Drake.
And I really think this is a deal where Coach Creighton is trying to get some sort of momentum or some sort of spark on the offense. And quarterback is a position that really runs Everything runs through the quarterback with this offense, and hopefully they can get something started, but they got a long ways to go.
They've changed the play, and now Entz fakes the handoff and is looking deep, and they're going for all the marbles. There's nobody there but defenders, and he just overthrows the defensive back on that side, who was Tejada.
And right there again, I questioned what the thought process of the quarterback on that play. They're not going to allow you to get behind them, Team Kind of Deep. Their defenders are going to play back. They're going to give you the underneath routes and underneath throws. Take your time, be patient, execute your offense, and throw the ball where it belongs. And you know, don't try to force anything, which is something, you know, both these quarterbacks have tried to do.
Flag before the snap, which usually indicates a false start. But in this case,
could be offside.
To indicate an offside. Someone from Kona Dape moving forward.
And with the there's a new rule with the American football at the college level. The defender, if he draws the offensive player offside, they're going to call offside penalty. So if a defender comes across the line of scrimmage, even if he doesn't touch him, and he kind of initiates that movement by the offensive line.
Call me old-fashioned, but I like it the old way.
If you move, I agree.
You're offside. If you don't move, you're fine. If he touches you, he's offside. If he doesn't touch you and gets back, he's fine. But I'm, you know, getting old.
Oh, no, no. I'm an old-school kind of guy. Now,
that pass was deflected before Entz could get it out. He had a receiver open, but it was blocked at the line of scrimmage.
And right there, it was that underneath route where, you know, someone goes deep and another receiver comes underneath behind that receiver on a shorter route. And that's there. That's been there all game. And I think if they, you know, move to that set and the quarterback makes the right read, it'll give them an opportunity to have some success.
So third down and about five now for Drake. Entz taking a little time to get settled and hands off, and there's a lot of running room there. It is a first down and more. A second effort will pick up extra yardage there. The running back is Brock LaFace.
Good job there of reading the blocks. They're in a hurry-up offense. They're really trying to get things going, get the ball moving. It's going to put the chain gain on it and get them on their heels. They got to get moving to get set up and keep this thing rolling.
It is one of the problems with the game as it's progressing and more and more teams playing in that hurry-up style is that the sidelines officials aren't always prepared for it. That one took a long time to get there and then was dropped when it did get there. Dan Hohenstein, the tight end that was out there and had space. And again, it just seems as if the Drake receivers are all thinking about the space they've got to run before they've secured the ball.
Well, I also see a double clutch there by the quarterback. But because Luis Valencia really got in the quarterback's face and Entz had to pull it down and then try to throw it and threw it again. So that may have kind of disrupted the timing of the pass and kind of threw it off. But you still have to catch the ball if it hits your hands, in my opinion.
So second down now. 10 yards to go for Drake. Still leading this game 3-0 in the second period. You saw the scoreboard on the other side of the field. And a bad snap, but Entz has it and gets it away. Safety valve, and they'll pick up a few yards on that.
I think that was
Jacob Schmudlock. Plays sort of as a slot back.
And I believe he got out of bounds. That's something right now with the clock running down with the hurry-up offense. No, he didn't, because like I said, the clock is still running. They have to get moving.
Again, a third and long, 6 yards for Drake. And again, they're changing the play. One's being called in from the sidelines, signaled by coach and the backup quarterback. Entz relaying the signals out to the three wide receivers to his right. And he's looking to his right. Releases, though, toward the middle of the field where the receiver was open, but short of the first down is Schmudlock. And that'll be a fourth down. And again, they'll have to kick the ball away.
And right there, I'm of the mind as a receiver, you have to know the down and distance. You have to know where you are on the field. And that's one of those routes where you just press it up a little bit more to where you can get some depth, you know, first down depth. You know, if you're going to catch the ball, you at least get the first down.
There's no point in throwing the pass if it's not going to get it. Jansen is in to punt again. Irving Barrera is again the receiver.
Be interesting to see if they try, you know, try to get a return, because last couple of times it's been fair catch. Not a very good punt there.
Jansen is trying to kick it into the corner of the field. He gets a decent roll, but it's going to be down at about the 25-yard line with no return. And the Mexicans will take over with a first and 10 at the 25-yard line. Kona Dape, last time they got down deep into Drake territory, can they do it again?
And you're looking at it, I mean, you have to wonder, you know, both these teams have had turnovers, you know, penalties that have really put them in bad situations. And the offense having success at certain points and then just faltering. Again, once they got into the red zone of the defender, things have just not, they've just not been able to execute at a high level, and that, I think that's really hurt them.
Race is in at the running back spot. He's been their best runner. But now they're going to throw on first down, and Race was trying to set up for a screen, and that one, was it intercepted? I think it was. Drake have intercepted. The screen was set up, but Ortiz really just drilled the ball past Race and past his three blockers. What they did was move some blockers forward, and Race moved in behind them to try to set up a screen for him, but Ortiz just threw the ball right past them and into the defender's hands.
And Tyler Moorhead did a great job of sliding in there and making a play. Hats off to him, because a lot of times that situation, you're not really, you know, you really don't know what's going on. So he did a great job of coming in there and making that interception.
And now Drake have been given great field position.
Can they execute their offense and give themselves an opportunity to put the ball in the end zone? We're in the red zone now, right on the edge of the red zone, at the 25-yard line. This is where, you know, as an offense, you have to execute. Nope. And you have to be that much more precise.
Now, there's been a change of plans. Been a change of plans, and the ball apparently hit the ground before the interception. And as you can see, the defense is back on the field for Drake, and it's second down and 10. So there's a turnover. There's a turnover of a turnover. And you saw Tyler Moorhead sort of limping off, but he is back on the field now. Second and 10 for Drake as they just dodged the bullet. For Kona Dape, sorry. They just dodged the bullet. And finally, they complete a pass for a short gain.
And I think that's what they're going to have to do. To get Ortiz on track, you have to have shorter, throw shorter routes to give him an opportunity to get some confidence throwing the football. Because right now, he hasn't shown a lot of confidence when throwing the football.
Just 2 yards on that pass. And this time over the middle. And again, he had the receiver there, but he couldn't put the ball for Ivan Pina, who was open on the middle. Actually, he had some yardage there if that ball was laid in the right spot.
That's the thing. I mean, it just seems like he's just a little bit off. He's not on the same page as the receiver. And you got to wonder, you know, got to try to find some. Coach Maya has to try to find some way to get his quarterback settled down and to find, get into a rhythm. And for a quarterback, when you're throwing the football, when you have incompletions, whether it's drops or, you know, bad throws, it kind of, you know, hits, you know, and has an impact on your psyche. He has to get into rhythm if Team Kona Dape is going to have some success moving the football.
That was a horrible snap from center, and that kick was nearly blocked, but Guy got it away. Short man takes it, and it's going to be a return. Flags are flying already. The short man was Lahard. He came up quickly, but the punt was nearly blocked, and then as he started the return, the flags went down. And I think it's an illegal block, because it looked like someone was blocked in the back just off the return by Lahard.
That's usually the case when the ball is thrown anywhere around the return man. It's usually a legal block in the back. That's what it is. That's going to move them back, putting them in a tougher situation. And it's actually a game of field position. You're losing field position with those penalties, poor special teams play. And I think that's the thing that's plagued this game on both sides of the ball. The poor discipline and so many penalties. Now, I mean, it was Team Kona Dape early. Now Drake is making some ill-advised mistakes and penalties, which are starting to cost them.
The Drake do keep the ball. They lose 15 yards, but it's their ball first and 10. Do you do therapy for quarterbacks who are having psychological problems? Or
well,
did you just
you
say,
would be
give
amazing.
Me the ball?
They have, like, you know, a lot of teams now, they'll have these team psychologists. I know we have one at Notre Dame. And it plays into your psyche, you know, when your guys are dropping balls, you tend to not want to throw to that guy.
Castro is back in at quarterback, and he's completed one quickly outside, and turning up the field is Nathan Paddock. And again, if they're going to give them the underneath stuff, they can go back to taking it. Pick up about four on the play. It'll be second down, 6 yards to go for another first down. And this is something now Drake hasn't been able to do since the opening of the first quarter, is to just move the ball consistently.
And it's just really those shorter passes are like, you know, long handoffs, and it allows the quarterback to develop some sort of rhythm and continuity with his receivers, and it moves the ball.
Castro just gets that one away. He had an underneath receiver, and that's going to be a first down and more. And again, with the he had three receivers going deep, and they brought the fourth receiver, Kevin Marshall, the tight end, underneath.
Underneath, I mean, that underneath coverage has been suspect all game, and I think, you know, Drake has to take advantage of that. But the biggest thing is, can they keep the defensive line off the quarterback consistently to give Castro time to make the throw? Good throw right there, good catch. Good yardage, and they're on the move again.
Castro looking to the sidelines to get the signal for the play, and again, just takes a straight drop and throws over the middle, and that one's intercepted. Zarate, the linebacker, he's returned it about 15 yards and probably run about 40 to do it, but Ivan Zarate, the linebacker, dropping back into coverage, and that one was probably the easiest interception he's ever thrown.
Exactly, and the quarterback and the receiver kind of gave up on the play there, but that's an ill-advised throw by the quarterback. Should not have thrown that football in the middle of the field. You don't throw the ball down the middle of the field, but it's really gotten the fans excited. That was kind of really one of the first plays where, you know, the fans got a little excitement going there, and they got up on their feet a little bit. But right there, good job of making the interception and getting some yardage on the return.
And Castro is down on the field as well now, which would be a huge blow for Drake, their second quarterback, to go out of this game.
That's a tough one. I mean, this is a tough one. And this is something Drake struggled with coming in, is injuries. And you hate to see that, you know, to have two, you know, your top two quarterbacks go down, you know, in one game. And that puts a lot of pressure on a freshman. I mean, that is not something you want to have to do. It's put the ball in the hands of a freshman in a game on the road, in a sense, in a different country, in a different environment. So hopefully Castro can shake it off and come back. But right now, I mean, that was an ill-advised throw, and it's one of those deals where he may have been a little off with the throw because of the hit.
Well, you can see he's holding his ribs. And he took a hit in the chest.
So we have the defense back on the field. That's one of those deals where, as a defense, you're like, come on, guys, give us a break a little bit.
Empty backfield now. Only the quarterback, Ortiz, is there, which usually indicates a pass. And Ortiz double clutches and now keeps the ball, and he's going to pick up about 5 yards before he runs out of bounds without being hit. And I don't know how he escaped from that rush, because it looked like he was a dead man back then.
Yeah, it looked like they were coming after him. They had a blitz on there, and you got five guys trying to block six. Somebody's going to come free, and that's what happened. Oh, and we have a penalty. Again, team kind of deep, shooting themselves in the foot, not really giving them an opportunity to move the football. When you have penalties that not only, you know, you lose field position, but it takes the takes your offense out of rhythm, and it also changes the way the coach has to call the plays. First and 10 is a lot different than first and 15.
That's right, and in fact, it would have been second and 5, so they go from second and 5 to first and 15. On the offside, penalty against Kona Deep. And you could see Drake's reaction. Kona Deep came out with no blockers in the backfield for the quarterback, and Drake just immediately rushed the extra pass rushers. They faked it this time, but and the screen was set up, and the pass was not there. But you could see that the blockers for Kona Dave let the rushers come in. Ortiz then threw the ball over the rush, trying to set up a screen with his blockers.
His touch has been off. I mean, that was almost intercepted by Michael Rattell. You know, he got a defender got a hand on it before for a kind of deep receiver. You know, he's just out of rhythm here. And, you know, you got to hope that they can find a way to get him back on track or get him on track throwing the football, because right now they're really struggling, or Ortiz is really struggling throwing the football.
Second and 15, and this time, well, there was no blitz, but it was just a wide open rush on a stunt by Brandon Coleman, the defensive end, who started on the left side and came behind the rest of the defensive line and then headed through unblocked and just dumped Ortiz for a loss. And that's going to bring up a third down and about 25 yards to go.
And I think that's the end of the that's halftime for us. Right there, you look at it.
The first half.
That was a deal where, you know, if you can get a rush with your front four, your defensive lineman, that makes a big difference, because it allows you to drop seven defenders and cover those different zones, and it puts a lot of pressure, especially for a quarterback that has really struggled to find an open receiver and make a good throw.
So that's the end of the first half. We'll take a break now, and we'll bring you some of the halftime action as you watch that last play, and there's Coleman making the sack. The score at halftime, Drake University 3, the All-Stars of Kona Dep, Mexico, nothing. Back with the second half and some of the halftime show as well. Don't go away.
Mtazamaji wa ITV ndio ule mpira wa American football kwa sasa hivi ni kipindi cha mapumziko, lakini Drake University wakiwa wanaongoza kwa mabao matatu, nyuma yao wakiwa na wale vijana kutoka Mexico wa Kona Dep ambao bado hawajapata kitu mpaka sasa hivi. Lakini wakati tunaendelea na shughuli nzima ya hapa uwanjani, turudi studio kwa muda ili kuweza kupata matangazo, na baadaye tutarudi kuona nini ambacho kinaendelea, ikiwa ni pamoja na mahojiano na viongozi wa serikali walioko hapa uwanjani. Studio.
The duffel bag, the brown paper bag, the Nike shoe box for holding all this cash. Okay. Boy, first pusher who ever made the stash. The rock boys in the building tonight. Oh, what a feeling I'm feeling life. Thanks to a little change, I took you out the cane. Bullet runners, stop your buffoonery. Thanks to the
play action fake, sharply. Plenty of time, plenty of time.
Naam, watazamaji wa ITV, mgeni rasmi hapa uwanjani kwa siku ya leo ni Mheshimiwa Waziri wa Viwanda na Biashara Dr. Cyril Chame, ambaye tuko naye hapa ili aweze kuelezea kidogo kwa uchumi wa Tanzania na ukuaji wa viwanda wa Tanzania. Uwepo wa ugeni huu hapa nchini utasaidia vipi? Shaka.
Asante sana kivuyo na kupata kutoka hapo studio jijini Dar es Salaam. Kinachoendelea kwa hapa uwanjani katika viwanja hivi vya Sheikh Amri Abeid mjini Arusha, kama unavyoonekana hali ya hewa bado ni nzuri na kuna burudani mbalimbali zinaendelea za wenzetu wa kabila la Wamaasai ambao wanawakilisha asili ya Tanzania. Na ikikumbuka kuwa mchezo ni mara ya kwanza kabisa kuchezwa barani Afrika, lakini ikiwa ni hapa jijini Arusha. Lakini katika mchezo huu pia tupo na viongozi mbalimbali akiwemo mgeni rasmi ambaye ni waziri wa viwanda, biashara na masoko, Dr. Cyril Chami. Labda Dr. Chami, katika ukuaji wa uchumi wa Tanzania, uwepo wa timu hii leo hapa Tanzania na siku zote ambazo watakuwepo, unadhani kutakuwa na ukuaji gani katika kipengele cha uchumi?
Asante sana ndugu mtangazaji. Kwanza kabisa ni vizuri tukafahamu kwamba timu hizi zinatoka nchi mbili. Moja inatoka nchi ya Marekani na nyingine inatoka nchi ya Mexico. Wameona kwamba wafanye mchezo. Hawakupenda kufanya Marekani wala Mexico wala Canada mahali pengine, wakaamua kufanya katika bara la Afrika. Na katika bara la Afrika wakachagua Tanzania. Kwa nini?